Hello students, today we are going to start with class 7 maths. That is, the topic is rational number. So first of all, I would like to tell that what is rational number. So rational number, we define that rational number like this: the number of the form p by q, where p and q are integers and q is not equals to 0. This is called a rational number. It means we are representing any of the number. If suppose I take 2 from here, 2. So generally what we can write, 2 means 2 equals to 2 by 1. So this is in the form of p by q. Clear? This is in the form of p by q. This is called a rational number. So if suppose means any number which is in the form of p by q, that are called the rational numbers. And so now coming to some other examples of this, like 4 by 5. This number is in fraction. So it is in fraction. And this is also in the form of p by q. Minus 7 by 9, it is also in the form of p by q. These all are the types of number which are a rational number. If suppose we take 0, so 0 we can write it like this, 0 divided by 1. So 0 is also a rational number. So what are the things? What are the things you have to point out over here? Means any number which is in the form of p by q is a rational number. First of all natural numbers. Okay, all natural numbers, integers, all the natural numbers, all the integers, these are 0, each and every number in fraction. Clear? So all natural number is, suppose 2 we are considering, 3 we are considering, 4, any number. So these are also that I am telling that rational number. If we are coming to integer, minus of 4. So minus of 4 can be represented it like this: minus of 4 divided by 1. It is also a rational number. Means negative as well as positive, all the numbers are means whatever comes under the integers, that are the rational numbers. 0, as I already said, that 0, 0 equals to 0 is divided by 1. It is also a rational number. Clear? So each and every fraction, okay, if suppose any of the number is in fraction, that are the rational numbers. Okay, these are the types of rational number. And now we are having some rational number like positive rational number, negative rational number. If suppose we are having 4 divided by 3, it is a positive rational number. What? Positive rational number. If suppose we take minus of 5 divided by minus of 3, it is also a positive rational number. Now coming to that negative rational number, minus 7 by 5 or 4 divided by minus of 5. What is it? This is negative rational number. So these are the positive means. However, whenever we will calculate, this denominator will come over here, the negatives, and when we will take common, then it will be negative. Here, this minus minus will be cancelled out, it will be a positive rational number. So these were the rational numbers. Now coming to that absolute value of a rational number. If suppose we have to find absolute value of any of the rational number, suppose we are having 4 divided by 7, this is a rational number. So in order to find the absolute value, what we do, we find the mode of the particular number. So whenever we find the mode of the particular number, then the signs are removed. Here what it was, if I have written 4 by 7, then a plus sign is hidden over here. So I have not done. So if we are doing finding that mode of any particular number, then the sign is removed. So I have not mentioned any sign. Then what is the thing that 4 by 7 means? A plus sign is hidden over here. So if we find the mode of the plus 4 by 7, then we will get 4 by 7. Suppose we are having minus 3 by 2, then here one minus sign is here, then when we will find the mode of this minus 3 by 2, then we will get 3 by 2. This is called the absolute value. In absolute value, what you have to do, you have to just remove the sign given over there. That is the absolute value. Equivalent rational number. So what is equivalent rational number? If suppose we take, let p by q be और रैशनल नंबर what am I taking? We are taking p by q is a rational number where q is not equals to 0. Here I am writing q is not equals to 0. Then in this condition, if we have to find the equivalent rational number, then what we have to do? We have to multiply this p and q both with a non-zero integer. What I am telling? Non-zero integer. With that particular, you have to multiply this p and q. Let we means if n is non-zero integer means I am telling the integer which is excluding zero over here, that is called non-zero. So if suppose we have to find that equivalent, then what we will do? P by q, this is further multiplied with n by n, then whatever we means this is the process to find the equivalent. I am giving one example by taking one numeric value. So if suppose I take one numeric value like 3 by 2, I have taken this particular 3 by 2 as a rational number. Now I am telling, means here I am taking that this 2 by 3 is a rational number, and in place of n, okay, first of all in place of n I will take 1, okay, after that I will take some other number. So what is happening? 3 divided by 2 is multiplied with 1 is already over here, so multiplying with 2 over here. So multiplying with 2, then what is happening? This will become 6 by 4. This is a rational number. What is happening over here? When we are multiplying this with 2, then the number produced over here. So this is equals to 3 by 2 is equals to 6 by 4. This both are same. Means we are not changing the value. We are not playing with the values over here. What we have multiplied to, which is common in both numerator and denominator. If suppose in the second condition, this 3 by 2, what I am taking, 3 by 2 multiplied with 3, then we are having 9 over here and 6 over here. So what I want to tell, that 2 means that 3 by 2 is equals to 6 by 4 is equals to 9 by 6 and so on. So these all are equivalent, means we have taken, earlier we have taken 3 by 2, then I have multiplied 2 over there, then it converted into 6 by 4, which is also equal to 3 by 2. Again, I have multiplied that with 3, then it has become 9 by 6, this is also equal to this. This is called the equivalent rational number. Now coming to exercise, which is 4.1, and the first question it is given that write 3 rational number equivalent to minus 1 by 3, means we have to write 3 rational number which is equivalent to minus 1 by 3. So what is the number minus 1 by 3? So first of all, in this particular, what we have to do in order to find the equivalent numbers, we will do that we will multiply this with the common number which was n. And what is n? I already said n is the non-zero integer. So first of all, let me multiply this with 2. I am multiplying both numerator and denominator with 2. You know what is happening over here? Minus of 2 and 6. The first equivalent rational number we have got over here. That is minus 2 by 6. If suppose minus 1 by 3, we multiply this minus 1 divided by 3 with any other number, suppose 3 we are multiplying. Then what we are getting over here? Minus of 3 divided by 9. This is the second equivalent number. Now again minus 1 by 3, what we are doing? We will multiply with a negative number. Suppose we are multiplying with minus of 4. So putting one bracket over here, the two signs are coming in common. So minus 1 is multiplied with minus of 4. Minus minus, when minus is multiplied with plus minus sign, then it is cancelled. So here we are having 4 over here. Again here we are having 3 and multiplied with minus of 4, then minus of 12. So further we can write it like this also, minus of 4 by 12, but keeping it in this form only what we have got. So this is the third rational number, which is that. So we can write that 1 by 3, the equivalent rational numbers, that is, we can represent it like this. So these are the equivalent rational numbers over here. So now I am coming to question number 3. Rewrite the following rational number in the simplest form. So we have to write this particular in the simplest form. We have taken the first bit of this, that is minus 45 by 115. So minus 45 is divided by 115. Here what we can do, we can write that 9 is multiplied with 5 divided by again 23 is multiplied with 5. Then what we can do over here, we can eliminate this 5 from here. Further, we will eliminate this and we will write that minus 9 by 23. This is the way how to find the convert that in the simplest form. And one more thing is that in question number 2, what you have to do, you have to compare the number. So just you find the common and eliminate that in the same manner. Just you have to eliminate the same number. So that by that particular way, you have to complete question number 2 and 3. Coming to the next type of question. In this question, it is that said that draw a number line and represent the rational number on it. We have to draw one number line and we have to represent this particular rational number on the number line. So first of all, how to make the number line? So we have to make one straight line. And after making this straight line, we have to mark the center with or the origin with zero marking. Why I have marked this with zero over here? This side I will take the positive numbers and this side I will take the negative rational numbers. Clear? So if suppose this particular is the distance of 1. So if we are coming to this particular side with the same distance, it will be minus 1. If we are coming to this with the same distance, this will be 2 over here, and this side with the same distance, it will be minus of 2. This is the number line where which is marked from minus 2 to 2 over here, and this is showing that it is going on, means it is going towards the negative term more and more, up to minus infinity it will go, and this is showing that it is going towards the positive infinity. So what is the requirement over here? We have to show this 4 by 5 over here. So in order to represent 4 by 5, this particular number line is enough to represent. So how to represent? We have to represent this 4 divided by 5. Means what it is said, it is dividing, means in the fourth part of that, we will divide this particular in 5 part and that. So 4 by 5, how can we get? 1 by 5 plus 1 by 5 plus 1 by 5 plus 1 by 5. So we are getting that 4 by 5. Clear? If we are adding one more 1 by 5, then it will be equals to 5 by 5 than 1. So in order to represent, means this is the first, second, third and fourth. What we will do? Here the denominator is given here 5. Then we will divide this particular 0 to 1 in 5 divisions. So that particular division would be equidistant. We are dividing. So 1, this is 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th and 5th. These are the 5 divisions. And this particular will be named as 1 by 5. This particular 1 by 5 plus 1 by 5, 2 by 5. This particular 3 by. So this particular 1 by 5, this will be 2 by 5, this will be 3 by 5. And this particular number will be 4 by 5. And what is the value of this? This is 5 divided by 5. 5 divided by 5 equals to 1. We came up to 1. So this particular number line means this is the representation of this particular point is the representation of 4 by 5. So in this particular way we have to represent in a number line. If we are coming to any of the non-negative number, if suppose we have to represent minus of 2 divided by 3. I am not taking any other means number line, explaining on this one number line only. So for that, what I have to do, everything is same over here. If I am representing minus 2 by 3 in the same number line, so minus the number is negative, then it will move from this side. So what we will do, minus 2 by 3, what we have to do, I already said what is the denominator over here, denominator is 3. Then we will divide this particular in the 3 division, 1, 1st, 2nd and 3rd. 3 division we have divided and we have to represent minus 2 by 3. Minus 2 divided by 3 we have to represent. So this will be what? Minus 1 by 3. This particular will be minus 2 by 3. This is the number line representation of both negative and positive. I already explained over here. Clear? So I have explained 4 by 5 and minus 2 by 3 in one number line. And if it is given in the question to represent, then you have to make this separately. Thank you.